Mark chapter 4. There you go. Mark chapter 4. If you're ready, say I'm ready.
I'm ready.
We begin a series on March Madness. We begin a series on March Madness. And it's all we're using March Madness as a theme for the month. Kind of focusing on somewhat using as an illustration of the basketball March Madness, which means the ultimate goal is to win the championship. The ultimate goal is to win the championship.
Amen.
But before you get to the championship, there have to be something else involved. Are you ready for this? Mark chapter 10, we're going to read quite a bit of verses, and then we will sum this up. It says, when he was alone, the 12 and others around him asked him about the parable. He told them the secret of the kingdom of God. Somebody said the secret of the kingdom of God.
The secret of the kingdom of God
has been given to you. But to those on the outside, everything is said in parables so that they may be ever seeing, but never perceiving, ever hearing, but never understanding. Otherwise, somebody say otherwise.
Otherwise.
They might turn and be forgiven. Then Jesus said to them, don't you understand this parable? How then will you understand any parable? The farmer sows the word. Some people are like seeds along the path. Somebody say the path. Where the word is sown, as soon as they hear it, Satan comes. Take it away. The word that was sown in them. Others seed sown on rocky places. Hear the word and at once receive it with joy. But since they have no root, they have last only a short time. When trouble or persecution come because of the word, come because who? Persecution and trouble come because of who? Persecution and trouble come because of who? They quickly fall away. Still others like seeds sown among thorns. Hear the word. But the words of this life, the deceptions of wealth, the desires of other things come in and choke the word, making it unfruitful. Somebody say unfruitful.
Unfruitful.
Others like seeds sown on good soil. Good soil. Hear the word. Accept it. And produce a crop. Some 30, some 60, some 100 times what was sown. Some 30, some 60, some 100 fold return.
Yeah.
I just wonder today, I know you looking for and expecting your tax return. Time? Some of you claim somebody else's kids so you can get a better tax return. Some of you lie so you can get a better tax return. All of it you do it because you want what? A greater return. So we'll do whatever we got to do in the natural.
Yeah, yeah.
To get
yeah.
a better
return.
Oh, y'all don't want to talk to me today. A better return.
Yeah.
I want to talk to you today. I want to talk to you and you and you and you, 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 you about the potential of a champion. I want to talk to you about the potential of a champion. I want to know today, do you feel like a champion? I didn't ask you is everything going good. I just want to know, do you feel like a champion?
Amen.
Father God, bless this word. I can't preach it without you. I need you today, God. Father, give me the wisdom. Give me the understanding that I may speak clearly and precisely right to the need that each and every one of us are requesting today.
Amen.
It is in the sweet name of Jesus we pray. Amen. Amen. This month we begin a series. We will be talking about the potential of a champion, the picking of a champion, the process of a champion, and the pathway of a champion. Repeat after me: the potential of a champion, the picking of a champion, and the process of the champion. The
process of the champion.
And the pathway of the champion.
The pathway of the champion.
The picking, the potential, the picking, the process, the pathway. The potential, the picking, the process, the pathway of a champion. And the thing is, here's the key. Before you even get to be a champion, you got to already have the confidence of a champion.
Oh, yeah.
Amen. So I can't take you to the Final Four if you don't already believe that you're a champion.
That's right.
Look at somebody say, huh? I just want, do you feel like a champion?
Amen.
Please don't go to sleep on me today. I put my microphone on today so I can holler at y'all. Can we just talk? It's just me, you, and Uncle Mark. Me, you, and Pastor. We just want to talk today. The potential of a champion. What is the potential? Potential is having or showing the capacity to become or develop into something in the future. Potential. Having or showing the capacity to become, to develop into something in the future. You gotta have the capacity first before you can develop. You gotta have the capacity before you can even become something in the future. God put it like this, and I said I've been saying this for quite some time now. In Jeremiah 29:11, he said, I know the plan I have. He didn't say, hey, I have toward you. He said, it's not of evil, but of good to bring you to an expected end. But sometimes it seems like that expected end ain't gonna ever come. Man. Look at someone and say, really?
Really?
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Sometimes we feel like it ain't gonna ever come. We gonna use the theme of March Madness. You piggyback on the event that's going on for the month. And everybody put together their brackets. And everybody put together who they think gonna win. And there are some that we have already expect to be in the Final Four. I mean, it just comes with it when you call their name. You already know. They are expected to be in the Final Four. Matter of fact, they don't even recruit you if they not expecting you to carry them to the Final Four.
Oh, yeah. Amen.
But they ain't going to get them just because they can play good. They got them because they had the talent. They had the ability. They believe that they are a champion. And you don't going to get somebody to win a championship if you don't believe already that they are champions. I got one clap. Hallelujah. I pray God for that. One clap, they clap three times.
Amen.
I thank God because he picks those that don't look like a champion. Yeah,
that's right.
In the event of the March Madness, there are 64 teams down at this point, and then there will be 32, then there'll be 6, and then there'll be 8, and then here it is, the final 4. Some of us get excited when the Sweet 16 comes. I don't even watch basketball that much until the championship is on. I don't really watch it because that ain't really what I'm into.
Right, right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
So I don't really care until I see some glimpse of the championship is coming. I hope y'all catching this. I don't really watch it until I see a glimpse of the championship is coming. And some of us are not watching and taking a glimpse of our lives because we are not expecting to be a champion or to have the victory.
Yeah.
Oh God. That means every day you're going to have to shake off how you feel, how you got to go back to practice. That means every day you got to put on your mindset that I got to work my behind all to get to where I need to be. And I can't sit down on the couch if I expect to win a championship. I love playing football, y'all, but I hate it going to work out.
Amen.
That's why I'm first off preaching.
Yeah.
Because I didn't want to work out.
Yeah.
I used to mimic daddy in the weight room because I didn't want to work out. I'm laughing over there. And then one of the coaches caught me and said, "Son, if you will be a champion, you gotta work out." I said, "The devil?" I rebuked him. I called him a devil. I called him a devil. But yet still I still had to go to practice. If I want to be on that team, I have to go to practice. Here it is. Some people got away with it because they were more gifted than I was, so they got a little bit more privilege, it seemed like.
Yeah.
Huh? Y'all better watch me because, see, you know, sometimes as a Christian, you look at everybody and you say, "Man, I go to church.
Oh, yeah.
I'm there with Pastor praying." Listen, I'm there every time the door open in mine. Here it is. I ain't getting none of my prayers answered. You rebuke the devil till you start wheezing. I rebuke you in the name of Jesus. Because you wore out. And never rebuke the devil till you start wheezing. Okay. Y'all are so fake. But then here it is, in the March Madness, here it is, there is a team that they call. Now y'all can catch me, help me if I'm wrong, because I don't know much about basketball. There is a team they call the Cinderella team. That means they are the underdog. They don't have the gifts or the talent like everybody else. They would have never been on a bracket to even go to the Final Four. But they are the Cinderella team that something happened and all of a sudden they start beating every giant that was in their way. They were the Cinderella team. Nobody even saw them coming. They name never been announced. Every now and then they have what they call a Cinderella team that all of a sudden they get some gifted people together that just are normal. I'm talking about just a normal. They take some normal people and turn them into some superstars. Oh God, turn them into superstars so they can become the champion that everybody least expected. Oh God, oh God. That people least expect for you to be where you are right now.
Yeah.
Oh, somebody should have shouted right there.
Yes, sir.
So they were the Cinderella team. And so all the time. Now, let's go to the text. Because, see, I want to talk to you about the potential of a champion. Point number one is the seed of potential. The seed of potential. Here it is, Jesus, before he got to talking to the disciples, he was preaching and teaching. He was teaching, and his teaching drew a crowd so large that he had to get in a boat. They sat on the shore and listened to Jesus teach.
Yeah.
He didn't have no microphone. He didn't have no headset, but he had power. Oh, y'all didn't say that name. He wasn't preaching what everybody else was preaching, but he had power. Look at somebody say, you got to work what God gave you. Oh, God, you got to work what God gave you. See, the thing is, we so busy trying to imitate other people. We ain't working what God has given you. And the reason why you are so drained, because you trying to be somebody else rather than being yourself. But God said, I'm about to show you that I will work whatever you have in you. And God said,
Let me get back up here.
And Jesus began to explain. I'm going to move from one lap from there to here right now, but I got the microphone, and y'all can hear me breathe. Jesus began to talk to the crowd, and he was telling the crowd about this former sowing seed, and he talked about the path. The brothers came and ate it. He talked about falling on rocky places. He said, but it didn't have much soil, so it sprung up quickly, and because of the soil was shallow, he said the sun scorched the plant and it withered because it had no roots. He talked about the thorns. Seed fell on thorns. He said, which grew and choked the plant out, so that they brought forth no grain. And so then he said, but there is good soil. Somebody say good soil.
Good soil.
And there was good soil, and it grew, it produced a crop, and it multiplied. Look at somebody say it grew.
Supposed to have goals and ambition.
Yes, yes.
But we're supposed to take it one day at a time. If you follow me someday, you probably think I'm bipolar. I asked the church on Wednesday, and I got this from my boss. Y'all want me to tell you what he said?
Yeah.
All right. He said, when you walk in the room, do you bring life to the room?
No.
Or do you suck the life out of the room? Oh, I was going to shout that word. He made it. When he said that, he just made a slam dunk in my spirit. Somebody get that for me. He made a slam dunk in my spirit because that resonated in my spirit. Because sometimes we do you know who you represent? Because when you know who you represent, you when you come in the room, nobody really asks you how you doing. They really don't care how you doing.
Mm.
If you tell them what's going on, I promise you, they'll start going the other way.
Yes,
they will. So now you faking it because you ain't really feeling what you're telling them how you feel. Okay, so let me talk to you a bit about this real quick. Let me talk to you about it real quick because I'm going to go on my time. Okay. Jesus, here it is. His disciples didn't understand what he told the people. Can I tell y'all another secret?
Go ahead.
Sometimes, as disciples, this series is built on disciples and discipleship. Sometimes as disciples, we don't always understand what he says. It's easy for me to preach the sermon. Y'all catch this. Than to live the sermon.
Yes,
sir. Mm. They don't want me to be honest.
Yeah.
It's easier, even though it takes me a while to put it together.
Yeah.
It's easier to preach the sermon.
Yes.
Than it is to live the sermon. Sister Kim said in this morning Sunday school, "How can you say you love? How can you possibly say?" Do what she said. How can you possibly say you love God and hate your beloved? Because in the book of John, he called the saints the beloved. So how can you possibly love God and you can't stand your brother?
Yes, yes,
you can't stand the beloved. Look at somebody say, "Are you the beloved?"
Mm.
Oh, all right. Because if you ain't the beloved, I ain't talking to you.
That's right.
Let's keep it real.
Yeah, that's right.
Y'all see that pose?
Okay.
All right. So, in our lives, so there are four areas of soil. The first soil is the pad, along the pad. The second one is what?
Rocky place.
The third one is what?
Thorns.
Okay. Along thorns and thorns. Okay. And the fourth one is what? Okay. He saved the best for last. Now he says here, the disciples didn't understand. So he said, I'm going to tell you the secret of the kingdom. He said, this is what we forget. We forget that the secret been given to you. Okay? You already know the secret. But the thing is, you don't want to obey the secret. Here it is. He So here it is. Our lives are turned. Boy, you have messed up my microphone. Our lives are turned around and we turn it. Come on. We turn it. Come on, close your eyes because you can't see. Now, here it is. Oh, close your eyes. Don't cheat. See, that's the problem with some of you saints. Right here. Now, I need you to find your way all the way back to that door and don't you open your eyes. Start loving somebody. That boy is not walking that straight.
He cheated.
The whole sermon. The thing is, let me, I'm going to explain to you. I'm going to explain to you what I was trying to teach you. Because he said, I'm so seeded to you. Here it is. I'm so seeded to you so you can reproduce and give the seed to somebody else. Your seed is not for you to keep to yourself. Your seed is to be given to somebody else. A farmer do not sow a seed and don't expect anything to come back just so he can eat. When he sow a seed expecting a return to be a blessing to me and everybody else around me. I just look at somebody and say, you show me a blessing. Look at somebody and say, you sure is blessed. I know that's country, but it's pretty good. Look at somebody and say, you sure is blessed. See, that's what I need you to talk to me. That's how I need you to talk to me. Because I need you to help confirm that I'm already blessed. I know right now I'm going through some things, but I need you to confirm in my life. Come on, son. I need you to confirm that I'm already blessed.
Amen.
So here the secrets of the kingdom. He said, I'm telling the secret of the kingdom. See, when we don't perceive and when we don't understand, we get discouraged. And the result of it, we don't find the revelation of God. When you find the word of God, you will find the revelation of God. Come on. When you find the word of God, you will find the revelation of God. The word of God guides you to the secret things. Because the revelation of God, it guides you to the things that's not seen in the scripture. And some things you will not be able to explain, but you just will have to be able to sense that God is leading you to a different destination, to a destination in your life, other than where you are right now. What if Joseph would have kept in the pit, and then if he had revelation, he would have stayed in the pit if he did not have revelation. When he got lied on, he would have stayed in the prison if he didn't have revelation. Oh God. His revelation brought him manifestation. Y'all ain't giving me a chance. This is some good preaching to me. I ain't playing. Y'all look at me like I'm crazy, but this is some good preaching to me. Y'all quit looking at how I look on the outside because I have more ability than you think that I have. And the reason why I haven't tapped into it because you don't believe that I have it. God, Almighty, that was good to me. That was good to me. If you believe that I have it, I might tap into it. Because here it is. Because you believed in it, it helped me to see God for the secret things of the kingdom that I should have the ability to do. But because you believed in me, it helped me to get to the place where I see God for the secret things that belong in the kingdom. The secret things everybody can get. Everybody can get the word, but everybody can't get the secret things. Since you don't want to talk about revelation and manifestation,
come on.
Let's talk about your potential. Yeah. Because they don't see what I see. They don't hear what I hear. And so therefore, you got to keep walking until the manifestation and the revelation and have a visitation of what God have already spoke to you. You can't have no revelation if you don't have no visitation. You can't have no manifestation if you don't have no revelation. So in order for you to have a manifestation and a revelation, you got to have a visitation.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Did you get that?
Yeah.
Y'all need me to rewind and say it. You can't have no revelation if you don't have no manifestation. You can't have no manifestation if you don't have no visitation. In order for you to have a visitation, you're going to have a revelation to give you a manifestation. Y'all got that? Okay. Now, watch on YouTube. trying to get the numbers up. Y'all hear what I'm saying? But anyway. Okay. Okay. Potential is unpredictable. I got 5 minutes. Potential. In order for you to find the unpredictable potential, you have to be patient, you have to be persistent, you have to have perseverance, and you have to be persistent. And you have to know that you have purpose. Okay? Some of that you have purpose, you won't find out until you walk it out.
Amen.
Yes, yeah.
God reveals your purpose when you start walking. So therefore, you can't get to the final form if you just stay at home and don't watch. If you don't get to practice, you got to come to practice so you can get the coach to help you believe in who you really are.
Yeah.
Oh, God. Look at, I don't really feel like I'm a champion, but because the coach keeps saying I believe in you. Do you believe in you?
Mm.
Do you believe in you? I believe in you. Do you believe in you? I believe in you. Do you believe in you? I just want to know, do you believe in yourself? I want you to understand. I want you to know that you are a champion. I don't care if you're on the A list or the C list or whatever list. I want you to know that you are a champion. I don't care who said anything about you. You are a champion. I don't care what they said. You will never be. I don't care what you've been through. I want you to know that you are a champion. I don't care. Yeah. say face up, you gotta get past some fears. When I say face up, you gotta believe that you're valuable. When I say face up, you gotta believe in the revelatory knowledge that God has already given you. And you gotta make better choices. You gotta make wise choices. And the only way you're gonna be able to make wise choices is that you're gonna have to get to God and get to know the secret thing. But I'm trying to tell you today, oh, it is that I swear the power on the hand of you. You got to understand that when you connect with me and I continue to connect with you, it helped me to understand who I am. It helped me to understand who I am. Look at somebody and say, I believe in you.
I believe in you.
I believe in you. I believe in you. I believe in you. I believe in you. I believe in you. I'm going to keep on until I believe in you. I'm going to keep talking until I believe in you. I'm going to keep walking until I believe in myself. Yeah. Most of us are not living a level of potential. We are still living on the level of preparation.
Right.
Yeah. Some of us are not living on the level of potential because we are still living on the level of preparation.
Yes, Lord.
When you gonna be ready?
Yes.
When? You gotta get out of the level of preparation if you're gonna go to the final four.
Yeah.
When are you gonna be ready? How long did that keep preparing? You ought to have a routine, some type of routine in place. When God gives God something to work with, all you're giving him to work with is excuses.
Mm.
All we're giving him is excuses. All we're giving him, come on, Christian. All we're giving him is excuses. Sometimes, can I be honest? Sometimes I'm living in. I take off my mask so I can't look at you. Sometimes I feel a hope and potential, but I keep living in preparation. Yourself. living in. Now I can't speak for you. Sometimes I can't reach my full potential because I keep living in my problem. Sometimes I can't reach my full potential because I keep living in my pain. Sometimes I can't reach my full potential because I keep living in my past. And all I can be a
give you some seeds. If you
going to reach your full potential in this madness. You're going to have to reach out of the rocks and put their feet, choke out your potential. If you're going to
again.
If he can get you just to get off the bench and say, Lord, coach, put me in. But some of us now, we don't even want to try to get back on the court no more. All the madness has gone through our lives. We don't want to get back on the court anymore. Stand on your feet.
And you have to demonstrate your faith.
What did I just say?
You have to activate your faith.